Assalamualaikum students, I hope you all will be fine and in good health and in good spirit as well. So here is the second part of my lecture on Oedipus Rex, and here I'm going to analyze the most important textual lines again. So let's start it. So here I'll start the story from where we are left with. In previous lecture, I have stopped the analysis when Creon has reached the palace with the words of Oracle. हमने last lecture तब वहाँ पे छोड़ दिया था जब Creon जो है वापस palace पे पहुँच गया था and Oedipus was talking with the priest and the countrymen regarding that famine, regarding that plague, जो curse उन पे आया था उससे accordingly वो बातें चल रही थी और वहाँ पे उस time Creon पहुँचता है. Oedipus has sent Creon to the Apollo for the to consult that oracle about that famine, about that plague, जो situation है वहाँ पे plague की, famine की, तो उसको discuss करने के लिए, उससे guidance लेने के लिए Oedipus has sent Creon to Delphi. अब Creon जो है वो वापस आया है. And here Creon says that, then let me report what I heard from the god. Lord Phoebus clearly orders us to drive away that polluting stain this land has harbored. It will not be healed if we keep nursing it. Creon says that the person, the culprit, the criminal, the guilty one is in our land and we are nursing him, we are feeding him, and that polluting stain, वो जो pollution का stain है, वो person हमारे अंदर मौजूद है और हम हमारे साथ रहता है, खाता पीता है, and और हम उसको जो Lord Phoebus है, उसने clearly कहा है कि हमें उसको निकालना है अपने मुल्क से. अगर हम इस curse से निकलना चाहते हैं, इस situation से, इस डेडली सिचुएशन से निकलना चाहते हैं, देन वी हैव टू ड्राइव अवे दैट फ्लोटिंग स्ट्रेन. ठीक है, देन Oedipus इज क्यूरियस, वो पूछता है व्हाट सॉर्ट ऑफ क्लींजिंग एंड दिस डिजास्टर, हाउ डिड इट हैपन, कि हम किस तरह से अपनी लैंड को क्लीन कर सकते हैं और ये डिजास्टर और इस डिजास्टर से और इस ये किस तरह होगा. Creon, बाय बैनिशमेंट, कि उसको इस मुल्क से निकाल दिया जाए, ठीक है, तर्क वतन कर दिया जाए, और अटोन फॉर मर्डर बाय शेडिंग ब्लड अगेन. अटोन मींस रिपरेशन, कफारा अदा करना, एंड ही सेइंग दैट दैट वी हैव टू अटोन हिज मर्डर, उसका ब्लड हमें लेना है, और दोबारा से ब्लड शेडिंग करनी पड़ेगी, उसको मार दिया जाए या उसका उसको बैनिशमेंट की सजा दी जाए, तभी ये ब्लड जो है ये हमारी स्टेट के लिए और हमारे कंट्री के लिए ठीक रहेगा, हमारे कंट्री के लिए ये जो कर्स है इसको ख़त्म करने में मदद देगा. तो यहाँ पे जो एक इम्पॉर्टेंट इवेंट आने वाला है ये उसका स्टार्ट है. इसलिए Creon और Oedipus जो है दे आर डिस्कस्टिंग द वर्ड्स ऑफ ओरेकल. This slide is again based on the conversation between Oedipus and Creon, and here Oedipus says that, and where are they, in what country, where am I to find a trace of this ancient crime, it will be hard to track. Here Oedipus is so determined and he is finding out the ways to search for that criminal, and here he asks from Creon that how I can find a clue regarding that ancient crime. He's saying this crime an ancient crime, bahut zyada waqt guzar chuka hai isliye isko ancient crime kaha hai, and it will be hard to track, ki ab itna time guzar chuka hai aur bahut mushkil hogi usko is crime ko trace karne mein. Then Creon says, here in Thebes, so said the god, what is sought is found, but what is overlooked escapes. So Creon guides him regarding the words of Oracle. तो उसने कहा कि in Thebes, he is in Thebes, वो हमारे बीच में है, हमारे दरमियान है. Thebes is the city, is the capital, जहाँ पे वो उनका पैलेस है, तो वो कह रहा है कि गॉड ने बताया दैट द गिल्टी पर्सन इज इन थीव्स एंड व्हाट इज सॉट इज फाउंड, जो कुछ हम ढूंढेंगे हमें आसानी से मिल जाएगा, बट व्हाट इज ओवरलुक्ड एस्केप्ड, लेकिन हम जिस चीज को नहीं फाइंड आउट करेंगे, हम जिस चीज को इग्नोर करेंगे, वो हमसे छुपा ही रहेगा. सो हियर द वर्ड्स मेक्स ईडिपस मोर डिटरमिंड दैट ही इज स्प्लिटिंग द हेयर, वो बाल की खाल उतार रहा है टू फाइंड आउट दैट गिल्टी पर्सन. सो ईडिपस इज वेल लियस फेल इन ब्लडी डेथ, वेयर वॉज ही एट होम और इन हिज फील्ड्स और इन अदर लैंड. सो हियर ही इज still questioning about the death of Laius, that how, what and when he it happened that created this deadly situation for the countrymen. So ye kab ka waqia kab hua and where was that Laius at the time of death, uski jab death hui tab wo kahan pe tha, at home, at field or at in an other land. So Creon says he was abroad on his way to Delphi. That's what he told us. He began the trip but did not return. That he was on the way to Delphi and he did not come back to Thebes. So Oedipus asked, was there no messenger, no companion who made the journey with him and witnessed what took place? A person who might provide some knowledge men could use. So he is asking about his delegation, that obviously a king is not a person who is a common person who used to travel alone. So here Oedipus is asking about his delegation, that is there no one with him who can guide us and who can tell us what happened to him. So Creon says they all died except for one who was afraid and ran away. There was only one thing he could inform us of with confidence about the things he saw. So here there is a clue regarding the death of King Laius, that Creon knows that there is a one person who ran away from that situation. He was with King Laius and he ran away from that place, and he shared them with full confidence what he saw. So here you see that after this conversation, Oedipus and Creon is able to find one person. So see the first line, first sentence of Creon, that what is sought is found. Usne kaha jo hum talash karenge to hame mil jayega. और यहाँ पे when they are splitting the situation, जब उसको खोल खोल के कि अच्छा ऐसा हुआ, अच्छा ये था, तो they are able to find a person, a solid clue to find out the guilty person. So here Oedipus is again asking, what was that? We might get somewhere if we had one fact. We could find many things if we possessed some cylinder hope to get us going. So here Oedipus seems to be hopeful ke acha there is a person, ab hum usse aur bhi bahut kuch maloom kar sakte hain aur usse hame hope mil sakti hai that we can find out that guilty person. So Creon says he told us it was robbers who attacked them, not just a single man, a gang of them. They came on with force and kill him. So यहाँ पे जिस पर्सन ने जो कुछ बताया है, तो यहाँ पे थोड़ा सा मिस इंटरप्रिटेशन है, थोड़ा मिसगाइड किया क्रियोन को. एंड ही टोल्ड देम दैट देयर वाज अ गैंग ऑफ रॉबर्स हु अटैक्ड किंग लॉयर्स एंड दे किल्ड हिम एंड ऑल दैट ना. तो वो ये एक स्टोरी उसको बता रहा है, एक एस्पेक्ट बता रहा है ईडिपस. How would a thief have dared to do this unless he had financial help from thieves? कि वो उसको kidnap कर सकता था, उसको financial help मिल सकती थी instead of killing King Laius. अगर उसने उसको मारा भी तो उससे क्या फायदा उसको मिला? तो again a question. Oedipus, as you know, is very intelligent in asking and predicting things. तो यहाँ पे वो इस reason को दैट देयर वुड बी अ गैंग ऑफ रॉबर्स उसको इसको निगेट करता है, ठीक है. एंड देन क्रियॉन सेज दैट्स व्हाट वी गेस्ड बट वंस लाइस वाज डेड वी वर इन ट्रबल सो नो वन सॉट रिवेंज. तो ये कह रहा है कि दैट पर्सन हु इन्फॉर्म्ड अस अबाउट किंग लॉयस डेथ, उसने हमें सिर्फ इतना बताया इट वॉज आर गेस दैट इट वुड बी द गैंग ऑफ रॉबर्स हु किल्ड किंग लॉयस इन दैट वे. एंड उस टाइम वी वर इन ट्रबल, और कौन सी ट्रबल थी इफ यू रिमेम्बर देन वहाँ पे उस टाइम स्फिंक्स थी, सिंगर, मॉन्स्टर सिंगर, जो लोगों को जिसकी वजह से मुश्किल थी. एंड पीपल हैव इग्नोर्ड the death of King Lois in that miserable situation. So again, logon ne apni misery ki wajah se, they have ignored the death of their king. So Oedipus says, when the ruling king had fallen in this way, what bad trouble blocked your path, preventing you from looking into it? Then Oedipus is asking about that your king was murdered, but you overlooked that situation. What was that trouble? Creon says, it was the Sphinx. She sang her cryptic songs and so forced us to put aside something we found obscure to look into the problem we now faced. So they were busy in solving that riddles that was put by that singer Sphinx. So they overlooked the murder of their king. Okay, here is the long speech delivered by Oedipus after knowing some clues from Creon that the person, the culprit person, the criminal is in Thebes, and they all are need in feeding him, they all are nurturing him. It means that the person is with them and spending his life with them. So now he is so enthusiastic to find out that culprit. He is so passionate to search that criminal. So here he says that in this I am acting as an ally of the god and also of dead Helios. And I pray whoever the man is who did this crime, one unknown person acting on his own or with companions, the words of Agnes will bear out his wretched life. This is a long speech of Oedipus, but I have included some of the important lines here. Oedipus says that from now onwards, I am the ally of God and of dead King Lois. Like, I am a person who is in their mutual, you can say that in their mutual position, I want to know who is that dead person, who is that culprit person, and I want to punish that person, and I want to make him a symbol of punishment for the people, for the criminals. So here he says that I pray whoever the man is who did this crime, one unknown person acting was on his own or with companion. It means that a person who is alone, the criminal, or is working in group, and a group knows that who is the person and they are supporting that criminal. So he says the words of Agnes will wear out his wretched life. Like, they're gonna be done a lot of suffering, a lot of miseries, a lot of punishment for that person, that, and he will mercy on his unluckiness of life. And he will mercy upon him, and he'll say that his life is and Oedipus says that he'll make his life wretched life, and he'll bear a lot of agonies, a lot of pain in his punishment. So the next important lines are, for my sake, for the sake of the god, and for our barren, godless, ruined land. For in this matter, even if a god were not urging us, it would not be right for you to simply leave things as they are and not to purify the murderer of a man who was so noble and who was your king. Here, Oedipus is talking about King Lois, that that we need to find out his criminal, and he was so noble and he was our king, so it is our duty to find out the person. It means that Oedipus has two reasons. The first one is that the king Laius is their king and they have to find out the murder. And secondly, it is for the sake of that barren land. It is the sake of that cursed land, that deadly plague and famine that barrened their land and ruined their land. So to make their land safe from that curse, they have to find out the murder of King Laius. So here he says, for my sake, for the sake of God, and for our barren God-ruined land, godless ruined land, it means that his own interest, and it is the prophecy from the God that we have to find out, and thirdly, it is for the land. So for in this matter, even if a God were not urging us, it would not be right for you to simply leave the things. It means that it is not only the God that who is forcing us to find out to in order to save our land, but it is not morally right to leave this thing and not to purify our land from that murderer, a murderer who is the culprit, who is the guilty person. So we have to do something to purify the murder of a man who is the king Laius. I hope you will understand all the aspect of this speech. This is the next part of the long speech delivered by Oedipus, and here he says that I'll fight on his behalf as if this matter concerned my own father. So prophetic lines, so symbolic lines. Actually, he is concerned with his own father. So here, I will strive to do everything I can to find him and the man who spilled his blood and thus avenged the son of Labdacus and Polydorus of Cadmus and Agner from old times. So here he is talking about the generations, that he is a man who spilled his blood for this land, and he is so concerned about King Laius as if he is his own father. So prophetic lines. And the next lines are, as for those who do not follow what I urge, I pray the gods send them no fertile land, no nor any children in their woman's womb. May they all perish in our present fate, or one more hateful still. To you others, you Cadmean, who support my effort, may justice, our ally and all the gods, attend on us with kindness all our days. So here, Oedipus seems to be more enthusiastic, more passionate to find out the guilty person, and he's saying that for those who do not follow, he is in doubt that maybe some of the person who do not take interest in finding out the murder of King Laius. But here he says that I urge and pray the gods send them no fertile land. It means that he is so much passionate that he want to not only punish that guilty person, but also those who do not follow Oedipus in finding that murderer. So no nor any children in their woman's womb, may they all perish in our present fate. Like, this is so deadly situation that is caused by that guilty person, that murderer of King Laius. So he's saying that that is the most crucial situation, that maybe the children in their mother's womb may perish. And because our fate, our present time is going to be ended because of that deadly situation. So here, he's so much concerned about the Cadmeans, the countrymen who support Oedipus. So here he wants justice, and he considers himself an ally of the god and ally of the king Lois, and he want to attend all the kindness of that days, means the soft word, the help from the god. So here the long speech clearly reveals the character of Oedipus, that how he is passionate about finding that culprit, and all the things that he says and all the promises he makes, he has to fulfill that promises. Students, this is the continuity of the important lines, and all the slides are in proper sequence. So I'm not discussing all the lines, but here I'm discussing only the important lines. So the next line from Oedipus, I feel it very important. So as he says that, Oedipus, that is well said, but no man has power to force the gods to speak against their will. So here, this line is very important, and theme of fate is revealed here. You can discuss this line under the theme of fate. So Oedipus says that there is no man in the earth that has power to force the god to speak against their will. So he says that the humans are powerless, and gods have power to speak. So no man is able to speak, and no man has power to speak against the will of God. So as it is said that a man is puppet in the hands of fate. This is a very famous line, and this line also supports fate. So you can quote these lines, and you can discuss these lines in theme of fate. So next, the chorus leader tells Oedipus that our Lord Tiresias, I know, can see into things like Lord Apollo. From him, my king, a man investigating this might well find out clear detail of the crime. So here, chorus leader tells Oedipus about Tiresias, that he is a person, he is the seer person, he is you can say that a person who is the spokesman of Lord Apollo. Like their god and goddesses won't speak the countrymen directly, so they have their own people to tell them. And then Tiresias is a person, an old blind person. So Tiresias here will come and reveal the truth to Oedipus. So here chorus leader says that I know, can see into things like Lord Apollo. From him, my king, a man investigating this might well find out clear detail of the crime. And these lines are important, because what chorus leader says, it happens in the next act. So on the summon of Oedipus, Tiresias comes in the palace, and Oedipus says to him, these lines are also very important, because these lines are ironic. Here Oedipus praises Tiresias, that you who understand all things, what can be taught and what cannot be spoken of, what goes on in heaven and here on the earth, you know, although you cannot see how sick our state is. So here Oedipus says that Tiresias is the person who can understand all the situation, although he is blind, but he sees what is happening in heaven and also on the earth. And here he says that that Tiresias is the one who knows the state of their the situation of their state. So here he says, and so we find in you alone great seer, our shield and savior. These lines are so ironic, because Tiresias is not going to help Oedipus very smoothly as he is expecting. So he says, that Tiresias is the only one great prophet and one great seer, and he'll definitely our shield and savior in that epidemic situation. And he says that for Phoebus Apollo, in case you have not heard the news, has sent us an answer to our question. The only cure for this infecting pestilence is to find the men who murdered Lewis and kill them, or else expel them from this land as exiles. So here Oedipus is telling Tiresias that you might not know that what Apollo has told us about the murderer of King Lewis, that he has sent us some clues regarding that person. So he is saying that we have to banish that person, we have to expel them out from this land as exile. In the next line he says, so do not withhold from us your prophecies from voices of the birds or by some other means. So we are not stupid as to hold the prophecies as voices of birds. कि हम उसको इस तरह के नहीं कि हवा में बातें समझें. वी वैल्यू द प्रोफेसीज एज वेरी ऑथेंटिक वर्ड्स. सो यहाँ पे ही इज क्लियरिंग हिज ओन पोजिशन एंड ही इज रिवीलिंग हिज पैशन टू सर्च फॉर दैट मर्डर. सो नेक्स्ट लाइन ही इज सेइंग दैट save this city and yourself, rescue me, deliver us from all pollution by the dead. We are in your hands. For a mortal man, the finest labor he can do is help with all his power other human beings. So here he is saying, and he is presenting his helpless situation, that we are the mortal man, we are the mortal human being, we have no power to find out the clues. So you are the person, you are the seer person, you are the prophet person, and you know everything. So help us out from this situation. So next, Tiresias says, alas, alas, how dreadful it can be to have wisdom when it brings no benefit to the man possessing it. This I knew, but it had slipped my mind. Otherwise, I would not have journeyed here. Here Tiresias says that alas means a very sorrowful condition, and that he is lamenting over the situation, that how dreadful the situation is, that having the wisdom, having the knowledge, but this knowledge brings no benefit. This knowledge will not give them relief as they were expecting. So here Tiresias, you know, that came with the mind that he will resolve the situation, but here he says that it had slipped my mind. When Tiresias sees that Oedipus is the person who is the culprit, so here he slipped his mind, he slipped his plan, and he says that that agar usko wo keh raha hai ki mujhe yahan pe lane ka ye maqsad hai aur main is cheez ko ab mazid nahi bata sakta. मेरा माइंड जो है वो चेंज हो गया है एंड आई विल नॉट टेल यू द ट्रूथ. यहाँ पे टिरेसियस अपने जो एक एम, जिस एम से आया था, वो अपने एम से फिर गया. वो कह रहा है कि आई एम नॉट गोइंग टू टेल यू द ट्रूथ. सो ओडिपस, व्हाट इज रॉन्ग, यू हैव कम बट सीम डिस्ट्रेस्ड, दैट यू हैव कम टू सॉल्व आर situation are riddle, but you seem distressed, that why you are so worried. So Tiresias says, let me go home, you must bear your burden to the very end, and I'll carry mine if you'll agree with me. Yahan pe Tiresias unko pyar se samjhane ke liye bol raha hai, let me go home and you must bear your burden. According to Tiresias, that the situation will remain the same, that everybody has to bear their own burden. जो जिस सिचुएशन में, जो सफरिंग्स में हैं, उनको ये बर्दाश्त करने दें, बिकॉज द वर्ड्स ऑफ गॉड रिवील्स द ट्रूथ, एंड दिस ट्रूथ कम्स विद मोर सफरिंग. ऑल दो कर्स हट जाएगा, बट द वर्ड्स ऑफ गॉड हैज अ लॉट ऑफ सफरिंग्स is the message of the Lord of Suffering. So here he says that I'll carry mine, कि मुझे ये दुख है, जाहिर है. Tiresias is a severe person, और उसे इस situation पे जो दुख है, वो कह रहा है कि मैं इस दुख को खुद बर्दाश्त कर रहा हूँ, and everybody has to bear their own burden. So वो कह रहा है कि you have to agree with me, और इस situation को as it is रहने दें. Oedipus, what you are saying is not customary and shows little love towards the city-state which nurtured you. If you deny us your prophetic voice, Oedipus इस situation को wrongly ले रहा है. Oedipus is saying that you have no love for the country and for the countrymen, that they are suffering, and they are suffering in this pestilence, they are suffering in this epidemic situation, they are suffering in this deadly famine and plague. So you have no mercy upon us, and you deny us your prophetic voice. You are not going to help us. Why? So यहाँ पे एक argument है, and Oedipus is unable to understand the situation of Tiresias, that why Tiresias is doing so. So here you will see the personality of Oedipus that is revealed through his anger, that how Oedipus is behaving with an old prophet, with the old seer prophet of Apollo, and he is creating an environment of hatred, he is creating an environment of anger through the dialogues of Tiresias. And here you will see the dark side of Oedipus. That before that, when the drama started, you have seen the positivity in Oedipus, that he talked with the countrymen, and he used to he was very sympathetic with that that people. So here you see the agony, or the because of the agony of the situation, it might be the Oedipus is behaving like that. But here the second reason is that the Oedipus is more hasty in taking decision. He is a man who can do action before thinking. So here your argument the argument between the Tiresias and Oedipus reveals the other dark side of Oedipus' personality. So here Tiresias says, I see your words are also out of place. I do not speak for fear of doing the same. Oedipus, if you know something, then by the gods, do not turn away. We are your suppliants, all of us. We bend our knees to you. यहाँ पे Tiresias says that it is not the fear of your personality, like कि मैं तुमसे कोई डर रहा हूँ और तुमसे कोई बात छुपा रहा हूँ. It is not like that. But he is fearing because of the situation that will create after the revealing of that truth. So Oedipus says that we are the suppliants. We are begging from you. We are upon your mercy, that you can heal us, you can save us from this pestilence. So here Tiresias says, you are all ignorant. You will not reveal the troubling things inside me, nor will I say it. They are your griefs as well. Here Tiresias is revealing the consequences before that truth. वो उनको नताइज पहले बता रहा है उस ट्रूथ से, कि तुम लोग इग्नोरेंट हो, एंड इट विल क्रिएट अ ट्रबल फॉर यू पीपल, मोर देन दिस ट्रबल, मोर देन दिस पेस्टिलेंस, यू विल फेस द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ दैट ट्रूथ, दैट विल बी मोर हार्डर देन दिस सिचुएशन, एंड दे आर योर ग्रीफ एज वेल, कि जो दुख हैं, जो एग्नीज हैं, जो पेन्स हैं, दे आर ऑल कवर्ड नाउ, अभी सब कुछ कवर्ड है. एंड डोंट ट्राई टू लुक इन टू द डेप्थ ऑफ दिस सिचुएशन. बट Oedipus, तो Oedipus है, Oedipus देयर, व्हाट आर यू सेइंग, Do you know and will not say? Do you intend to betray me and destroy the city? So, Tiresias अगर सच नहीं बताना चाह रहा तो इसको ईडिपस इज कंसिडरिंग अ बीट्रे. वो कह रहा है कि ये मुझसे कुछ छुपा रहा है, मुझे बहका रहा है, मुझे भड़का रहा है और मुझे सच जो है वो नहीं पता चल रहा. एंड दिस हाइडिंग ऑफ दिस ट्रूथ विल डिस्ट्रॉय द सिटी. वो कह रहा है कि अगर ये कर्स रहा, ये सिचुएशन ऐसे रही, देन ऑल पीपल विल डाई. सो ईडिपस इज मोर कंसर्न्ड अबाउट द कंट्री मैन, मोर कंसर्न्ड अबाउट इट्स स्टेट. सो टीरेसिस सेज, येट इवेंट्स विल स्टिल अनफोल्ड फॉर ऑल माय साइलेंस. सो देर इज ऑलवेज अ डार्क लाइन अंडर द ब्लू स्काई. तो ये जो साइलेंस है, ये साइलेंस इफ दे कंसिडर Tiresias a wise person, then why they are not accepting his wish? वो क्यों नहीं मान रहे हैं कि Oedipus is, if Tiresias is saying that do not force me to tell the truth, then why Oedipus is not accepting? Okay, ठीक है, Tiresias जो है एक wise person है, wise seer है, वो prophet है. अगर वो कह रहा है then we should not look into the matter. But Oedipus, since they will come, you must inform me. Tiresias, I will say nothing more, human, about it. If you wish, as fearlessly you can, as you can. So here, Tiresias and Oedipus both are arguing on their own part. Oedipus is determined to know the truth, and Tiresias is determined not to tell the truth. So let's see the next slide. So here now Oedipus says, I will, in my anger, I'll not conceal just what I make of this. You should know, I get the feeling you conspired in the act and played your part as much as you could do. Short of killing him with your own hands, if you could use your eyes, I would have said that you had done this work all by yourself. So here Oedipus is blaming Tiresias for that murder. You might have someone who is in support of you, and with the help of that person you might kill King Lois. So yahan pe shak jo hai sara wo Tiresias pe dal raha hai, that Tiresias is the person who is the murderer. Aur wo keh raha hai ki agar tumhari aankhein hoti then I'll say you that you are the person who killed King Lois. और वो कह रहा है कि अभी जो है this is the conspiracy against me and my state, that जो सच तुम छुपा रहे हो वो सच यही है कि you are the guilty person. So Tiresias says, is that so? Then I would ask you to stand by the words which you yourself proclaimed, and from now on not speak to these men or me. For the accursed pollution or the polluter of this land is you. So here, when Oedipus blamed Tiresias for the murder of King Lear, then Tiresias revealed the truth that if you are blaming me, then you yourself is the person who is the pollution of this city, this land, this country. So वो कह रहा है कि अभी तक जो तुमने claim किया है कि तुम उस जो कल्प्रिट है उसको जो पनिश करोगे, देन फुलफिल योर वर्ड्स, कि अब तुम उन जो कुछ तुमने कहा है मेरे बारे में या उस बंदे के बारे में जो गिल्टी है, देन यू हैव टू प्रूव दैट दी व्हाट यू हैव सेड इज ट्रू. देन वो उसको बता देता है दैट यू आर द पर्सन हु इज द मर्डरर ऑफ किंग लॉयस. So here again, I'm closing this lecture with curiosity. Like in my first lecture, when Creon has just reached with the words of Oracle, then I wind up my first part. And then now in second part, when Tiresias revealed the truth about the murder of King Lear, that Oedipus is the person who is the murderer. So now let's see what happened in the end of this drama. So wait for my third part and then I'll complete the story of Oedipus Rex with important lines. Thank you very much.